हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ तृप्ति कुलकर्णी एंड वेलकम टू माय चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द सेकंड चैप्टर ऑफ आईओटी व्हिच इज़ देयर इन द टीवाई बीएससी आईटी इन मुंबई यूनिवर्सिटी। सो यस्टरडे और प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन दैट इज़ द ओवरव्यू ऑफ आईओटी, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय आईओटी, then what are the different flavors of IoT, what are the components, how the equation is formed in IoT, so what are the sensors, actuators, all these things, what different terms are coming in IoT, that we have seen in previous lecture. Now moving further, we are going to go with the next sub chapter, that is the chapter 2, which is design principles for connected device. So here we are going to see what do you mean by calm and ambient technology, what is magic as metaphor, how you are going to keep all the privacy secretly, or the sensor, those who are going to sense the data, okay, or sense the inputs, whose data is it anyway, okay, then a web thinking for the connected devices, then the first class citizen on the internet, graceful degradation and the affordness. So these, all these points we are going to cover in chapter 2. So let's start with it. The very first topic is calm and ambient technology. So we will see first what do you mean by calm technology. So the calm technology is something like, you can say, in simple language, okay, in simple English language, when we talk about a calm word, calm is something like quiet, or you can say a silent, okay. So the same, you can say, concept is going to apply over here for the calm technology. Calm technology is a technology which is working quietly for you without seeking your attention. So he don't need to you supposed to communicate with that particular device. He will work for you and he will give you the output. For the calm technology, the definition says that system which don't vie for your information, yet they are ready to provide utility or useful information when we decide to give them attention. So this is the definition of calm technology. Moving further, these are the some of the, you can say, the principles of calm technology. So the first one is technology should require a smallest possible amount of attention. Here this is a fact that as we have seen in the definition that it doesn't require attention, or it doesn't require you should give some information, but the fact is that you're supposed to give the small amount of attention to that technology. Technology can't communicate directly, but even if they can't you can say speak directly to it, but they are going to communicate through the sensors and the actuator. Okay, so communicate information without taking a waiver out of the environment or a task. Suppose if I talk about a smart mirror, okay, so smart mirror is something like you supposed to go and you have to stand in front of a smart mirror. So that attention that a smart mirror required. So if you are going to stand over there, then only you'll get the information of your entire day. The second one is technology should inform and create calm. Okay, the technology should inform and create calm is first of all, whatever the you can say the devices and whatever the IoT objects we are going to create, that is for humans or for the society. So the person's primary task should not be a computing, okay, it should be being human. What are the requirements that you have to see? You have to give what is the need of the people, and you supposed to solve the problem of people, nothing more than that. So that is nothing but you are creating a calm technology all over the society. The third one is technology should make use of periphery. Periphery is something like whatever you can say surrounding is there, or whatever the changes are there happening in the environment, okay, you supposed to use that thing also. So you have to capture that thing also, and accordingly that you supposed to, your technology should work over there. The fourth one says that technology should amplify the best of it and best of humanity. So when you're designing a particular object or a particular IoT device, then you supposed to think like the best thing you can give to the society with respect to the humanity. It should not affect any harm to the it should always give some, you can say, the solutions to the whatever the problems the society may have with the good result. Okay, the fifth one says that technology can communicate but doesn't need to speak. As I told you that there will be a sensors and the actuators are going to be there, so they are going to communicate. It is not compulsory they're supposed to speak only. Okay, so in this manner, or you can say in this technology world, technology is something like where the devices and where the components are going to communicate. Communicate means nothing but the sending the information and receiving some information is a communication. So doesn't require they need to speak over here. So if I'm using mobile phone, okay, so why mobile phone is working? Because they are getting the electromagnetic waves from their stations or from their wherever the tower is placed out there. So again this again there is a communication is happening. We are seeing a TV, we are watching a TV, and why the TV are TVs are running over there? Because you can say again there is a dish is there and he's capturing, you can say, the waves, whichever the electromagnetic waves are passing. So this is again how the communication is taking place without a speaking a single word, still the communication is happening. So this is nothing but technology can communicate but doesn't need to speak over here. The sixth one is technology should work even when it fails. As we are in the technology world, if we are in the technology world, where you should have your backup plan whenever we talk about a technology. So even if a simple example I just want to give, whenever we go for a presentation or when we go for a particular exam or something, whatever the important files you may have, so that files you kept in one pen drive, two pen drive, at your email, so why you're keeping all these files at different you can say places? Because you want if any pen drive doesn't work, or if any there is no internet is there, so then I should have my backup plan. Same way technology should work even if it fails. So whenever if your system get fails, then you should have the backup plan for your technology. What should be the next step if the technology fails over here? And the seventh one is the right amount of technology is the minimum needed to solve the problem. So whenever whatever the problem you may have, okay, that supposed to get solved with the right amount of technology. Okay, you should not have some complex thing over there, but the perfect or you can say the accurate amount of technology is required over there. Nothing else is required to solve the any of the problem of the society or of any human over there. Okay, the last one is technology should respect social norms. As we talk about best of humanity, whatever the product you're going to launch and whatever the IoT device you're going to come up with, that should respect the social norms. It should not affect or it should not harmful to any of the you can say the community or any of the you can say the society over here. So you should respect always the social norms. So what examples we can talk about the calm technology? So here I have given the two examples, with a smart tea kettle and a smart badges. So here smart kettle or the tea kettle is works like whatever you can say whenever the teapot tells us when it's ready, and it is gets off and quiet the rest of the time. So tea kettle can be set and forgotten until it sinks. So tea kettle is something like the tea is going to get prepared, and as soon as it gets prepared, it will just give you some, you can say, the beep or something like lights is going to be come out, and it will take a rest of the time. It will be quiet for the rest of the time. The second one is smart badges, or you can say the smart cards which we are using. So if you want to get into a particular room, or if you want to get into a particular elevator or a lift, then you are supposed to keep that card in front of that you can say the machine, and then the touch, simply giving a touch of that card and the badges, the door will get open. So this is nothing but you can say the calm technology, how it works. Moving further, the next technology is ambient technology. So the ambient technology is completely different than your calm technology. So what do you mean by ambient technology, or and what is the definition of it? the most profound technology are those that disappear and they wave themselves into the fabric of everyday life until they are distinguishable from it. So ambient technology is something like you can say the technology which required your attention, or you can say which required you can say some of the inputs from you. That is nothing but ambient technology is all about. So as we have seen the calm technology is something like which doesn't require your attention and which will work quietly without seeking your attention. But ambient technology is also called as ambient computing. And this technology is nothing but you can say could use any of the combination of the different technology, like it can include the voice or the speech recognition, then the you can say the visual you can say the password can be there, then the wearable devices can be there, then the environmental factors can be there. So any you can say cloud computing, all these things can be tied together with the artificial intelligence, and then this is nothing but you can say the ambient technology. Now ambient technology is something like where you supposed to give the inputs and then only you will get some output. So the best example for ambient technology is something like nowadays you are seeing the Alexa. Okay, so Alexa is you can say one of the best example of ambient technology, where you supposed to, if you want anything or if you want to know anything about a particular thing or information, if you want, then you supposed to ask Alexa that yes, tell me about this thing, tell me about this and give me the information of this, and then only the Alexa is going to work over there. So this is nothing but the ambient technology is. The next topic is magic as metaphor. Magic is a very important you can say the word which comes in IoT. We know that this is something like we are working with a simple object and we are converting that object into the smart object, and that can be called as a magic over here. In addition to the technology, okay, becoming capable of particular action, or you can say doing a particular action, we often need a society to be ready to accept it. For example, whatever the device and whatever the object you are designing, that should be accepted by the society. As I talk about the you can say the technology, any you can say the device or you can say any object gets successful not in the starting phase. After years and you can say after a particular time period, when society accept it and you can say they are more you can say the receptive for that particular technology or the object, then it gets you can say the successful. So there are many examples when the main difference between the failed technology and successful technology is one, that the successful technology is always arrived after a few years, and after a few years later it becomes the successful. So when at the starting phase of the technology, it never it gets success over there. After accepting by the society, it would be a successful technology only. So for a technology to be adopted, it has to make it its way inside the manufactured normalcy field. So situation in which everything is normal, this is nothing but the normalcy field is. So magic as metaphor is something like what we have seen in magical world, or you can say in fantasy literature, the same thing can be possible in your technology world with the help of you can say the different you can say components and the internet and everything which is present in technology. So here you have one case study of Verdial. So Verdial is something like here it is. Verdial is one object which was shown in Harry Potter movie. where they track the location location of members of Weasley family. So there was one Weasley family, and from that Weasley family, the particular person is at where, that you have to check with the Weddell, you can say this machine. Okay, so this is shown in the movie called Harry Potter. But the same thing can be happened with right now with a mobile phone. So GPS is one, you can say the tracker which is there in your smartphones. Where the location can be checked, and you can get the updates of a particular person, where he has reached and where he is actually right now, that you can check with the help of GPS. So in simple terms, whatever we have seen in the magic world, or you can see the movies, so that the same thing can be possible with the help of technology. So that's it for today's lecture. In today's lecture, we have seen the two important topics of chapter 2, and that is a calm and ambient technology and magic as metaphor, and with that the case study of Weddell. So calm technology is a technology which is working quietly for you without seeking your attention, and exactly opposite of calm technology is your ambient technology, where it requires the attention. You have to give some inputs out there, so where you can say the voice, the speech recognizer can be there, then the other computing devices can be there, the cloud computing, with this all are tied together with the artificial intelligence, and that is nothing but your ambient computing or ambient technology is. Then magic as metaphor is something like none of the technology has become successful in its first phase only. Later on, and few years later only, if that technology is accepted by the society, then only that technology becomes successful. So that we have seen. Then we have seen the Weddell, where we have compared the two things, the Weddell and the GPS system. So Weddell is something which is shown in the movies, the magical movies, and the GPS is actually you can say the real time, or you can say the example where you can track a person where he has reached. So these points we have covered in today's lecture. So let's meet in the next lecture for the remaining topic of chapter 2. So thank you for watching my video, and please do share and subscribe my channel.